Hey everybody, it's AJ. Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be an animal care video. Are we surprised? Like, wow. So I'm going to be doing a cage tour of all my animals. I thought it was kind of funny because you know those videos, they have like 70 animals and you're like, you kind of have a hoarding problem and you see all these cages, but like you want that for your future. Well, I have two cages. So I'm going to be doing my hermit crab tank and my fish tank, and I'm going to show you one thing else that I'm not going to really talk about yet. So a lot of you know, a couple of videos back that all my hermit crabs died from some sort of disease that just got passed around. So I have three new hermit crabs. I named them after cities. Their names are Dallas, Boston, and Paris. And I have a new tank. A lot of you know for years I had a tub, a like tinted tub, and it worked great, but I decided to do a, tank just for a more simple, cleaner look, and the tub lid was kind of falling apart. The whole tank was kind of just like, you know, used. I needed to get something new anyway. Decided to just go with the tank, be easier and everything like that to find lids and stuff instead of having to cut the hole and do the chicken wire and everything in a plastic container. So it's going to be a new tank that I'll be showing you. It's a 30 gallon with three hermit crabs in, and I plan on getting a fourth in this tank. So let's get started. So this is the tank. One thing that I have to mention is I accidentally got a 30 long instead of a 30 regular, but I decided it actually works good for sand amount and everything like that, and they don't really climb up much, so I figured that a 30 long is actually fine. So the first thing you see is my infamous sign that I've had for years. I love this. You don't really see hermit crab things often, so when I do see them, I pick them up. The one thing I have to mention about this cage is the lid is like pretty frustrating, and it took me a long time to figure out how to make it secure. So it has these two like knobs that you have to turn. This is a lid that you like can do individually. I wouldn't recommend it if you have some sort of snake or like some sort of animal that can like easily figure things out, because this is kind of like simple, I feel like, to just like knock that over a little bit and it will open. But my hermit crabs don't climb and, you know, stuff like that. So if they did it, I'd put like a rock over it. So if you have some sort of animal that would do that, put like a rock over it. So then it opens up like this, but like completely comes off. It's kind of very weird. So then you come over here and we've got salt water and fresh water with these bridges. People ask me about these bridges all the time. I got them from like a lady that just kind of had her own little small hermit crab shop. So don't really know where you could get them, but you could probably search for them up online. But I love them so much. It's just very helpful for different sizes of hermit crabs because I can bring it out further and this can be kind of like shallow or deep. These are at a tilt so that there's a shallower part and a deeper part, so that gives a benefit for different size crabs. All my crabs are relatively about the same size, but I do have one bigger crab. So these are the shells, and I do switch out the shells, but right now they've just got a lot of turbos because, sorry about my finger, purple pinchers do like, or Caribbeans do like turbos, and there's a few that aren't turbos. So that's what I just kind of have now. Two little decorative shells. Their food dish right now, they have flower petals that I dried, some millet, celery, carrot, and this mix of like dried fruit and stuff. I would recommend when you have hermit crabs, going to like the bird section and finding their dried fruit and stuff is an amazing little hack. So over here I have this piece of coral and this wooden kind of structure. And what you're going to see is I kind of created a like setup that just has a bunch of little crevices for them to go in. So the bottom is this big opening, which they're all in currently, a big like rock kind of formation. And then on top, over here, actually, sorry, I have cuttlebone and like a little coral, and they can chew on that and stuff, eat that, you know, it's good for them. And then they can also just use it to climb up. So I'll start from actually the plants. So we've got this long plant right here. I'll push that to the side. Then we've got this yellow plant that goes straight up and a green plant that goes through. They really like plants, easy for them to climb on and grip and everything like that. But then I have this like rock formation with like kind of like a ladder type system or like stairs. And I put that on top so it gives them like another little crevice to go in. And then this, I'm not going to move it, but that's the rock. And then this, if you pick that up, you can see that there's two little caves. It's kind of hard to see, but in here, there's like a little spot and under here there's a spot, and they can go completely under this to go to the other side. So I just kind of put it like that, and they actually really love that, like the whole cave. They feel kind of secure and stuff. So there's like two caves. I'll fix this after. And then they can just go around to the back through the plants and over the other side. Simple setup, but I do like having the food, water, shells over here, and then having just kind of a cluster of different things. I do switch things out and move things around, and I will fix this. But yeah, just kind of gives them a bunch of little hiding spots. So that is the hermit crab tank with 3 hermit crabs in it. So this is my betta tank. It is a 5-gallon. It's from Topfin. I really love this tank. I've used this tank multiple times. This is actually the second one I got. It does come with a glass lid, but I particularly don't like that. I feel like I want, you know, good oxygen flow and everything like that. So it comes in with a built-in filter system, which I really like. I don't use the bags that it comes with. I use the regular size bags because so much cheaper, and they actually do better in my opinion. But there's a whole tubing system in there and comes out there, obviously. It's really spacious. It's 5 gallons, and I really like it. I think that it's a good height versus width. A lot of times you see tanks that might be too tall or too wide. Really like this size. So in it, I have these terracotta pots that I'm going to link below how I make these. Always get asked in every sort of cage tour video or anything like how these are made. So I'm going to leave that video linked below. But these are terracotta pots that I made into hides. So much cheaper than buying those like $30 formation things that just get a bunch of algae on them, and like it's hard to clean them. These are super easy to clean. Then I've got 2 plants and a low ground plant. Love these for my frog. Loves to hide in there. So and here's Riley over there, and the frog is right there. So I do need to get another snail and another frog. Unfortunately, the snail and frog have passed away, so I'm gonna have to get a new snail and a new frog, and yeah, the tank will be back to how it was. And there's a thermometer right there, and there's a light system up here. I almost forgot. I told you guys I was gonna add something in the end. Also, isn't this beautiful? I painted that myself. I will be doing a room tour soon, but isn't that really pretty? So I'm gonna show you something. So a lot of you guys know about my dog Sadie, and the first year we had her, she didn't play with toys, but she's lazy. So since we couldn't buy her toys or anything, and she had really bad stomach issues, so we didn't really buy much treats, we bought her beds. And so I'm gonna show you how many places this dog has to sleep in my house. She's got this bed, and she likes closets, so I made her this bed in here. One, two. This used to be in the corner and this was in the middle, but now we have a Christmas tree, so we had to move our couches. But as you can see, this dog has too many beds. And she has 2 little things outside, like 2 dog houses.